And we're back up here. Yeah, okay. Little splaining going on, little stuff gotta say around here.
Got it.
Some of you might be surprised, some of you might not be. In short, well, in the previous episode I was trying to defeat Thaos. I failed. I tried again. I tried a bunch more times, actually. And twice I actually got him to the point at which... I guess when he reaches when he's damaged by a certain amount, or down a certain percentage of health, he transfers either his soul into this, one of those guardian statues, or, controls it otherwise. Yeah, so that's as far as I got. A couple times I was able to level up. I leveled up, no, it was actually just once. I was able to level up Theodas and Pelagina right before the fight. There was actually a cutscene, not a cutscene, a save. An automatic save right there from right before when the battle starts. Basically unwinnable to me unless we make some incredibly unlikely save, like a lot of times. So I tried to leave. I killed everything in the Wraith Yemen, if I'm saying that right, and Sun and Shadow. So I'm like, well, we gotta get more experience. We gotta, you know, level up some more. And then we'll have a chance, you know. That's how role-playing games usually work. Can't leave. We cannot leave. And I tried to see if there was some way to leave, and that was a little bit of a cheat, but I didn't want to play everything all over again. Other than that, you know, it's still blind, but I found out that we cannot... Once you go down this hole, we can't come back. That's kind of a spoiler. Sorry about that, but, if you watched last episode, you watched as far as we can go without actually ending the game, which I have been told ends not long after you defeat Thaos. Once the game ends... It's ended. The end. You can't even access the White March expansions. You can't do anything once the game's left, except, you know, revert to an earlier save. But I'm talking about at that point, the game's over. Forever and done. So we cannot proceed with this. Because not only do I want to, you know, play through the White March Part 1 and Part 2 whenever it comes out, sometime end of this year, I think. Beginning of next year, somewhere around that. From what I understand. But I digress. I do want to play through that. And I do want to finish exploring the endless paths of Anua. And I do have some companion quests to do. We have stuff to do. But I figured, well, this guy has to be stopped. Let's just get rid of him. And then, you know, return and do this other stuff. Nope. Once you get rid of him, that's it. So, I'm kind of surprised no one warned me about this, but I guess, you know, you guys might have been afraid of me getting pissed about spoilers. Which, you know, is I could understand you being, you know, wary of that. But yeah, this is basically a death trap. Once we go down, we're, you know, not saying we're all gonna die. I don't know if that's the end. Don't say what happens, guys, please. But yeah, this is... We're going to continue on from here. We're going to finish exploring that dungeon underneath our stronghold. And we have companion quests to do, and then there's the White March expansion. So this hole is going to wait until, I guess, White March Part 2 is done. I'm assuming that's going to be their final expansion. DLC, what have you. I am quite a bit put off that the game really doesn't warn us. I mean, it does say pre-end game, you know, on this autosave. But I had no idea. You can't... Every other game I've played, you can play through the thing and then load an expansion and play that. Not so with this one, from what I understand. So, I'd say this game is 9.0. I'd give this game a 9. Up until that point. It just lost an entire point, in my eyes. By having this ending and then having an expansion and not even... they may have told us, but maybe I wasn't paying attention, guys. I don't know. I figured we could take care of the entire... everything in the main game and then play the expansion. Why the hell not? Finish the game first and go to the expansion. Seems like a logical progression to me. So, I'm going to stop babbling. We're leaving this area, which makes no sense to the story. We'll just say Thaos had a premonition that we are not able to defeat Thaos at this point, and we're heading to our certain doom, being a watcher and a cipher. It's theoretically possible that you might be able to tell that. Maybe even by the help of these souls. Maybe these souls have an idea of how strong Thaos actually is. And the
this
stone...
This is great and all, but I think I'd be having more fun swinging from that tree back home.
I got you there. Anyway, so maybe these souls have an idea of how strong this is and or urging us to continue... to come back here after we've gained more experience in fighting and have gained more powers as we have been doing throughout our quest, so it's entirely believable that we will continue to gain power, especially once we learn of this White March. meta parentheses, you can get to a higher level than the White March. Now I'm not sure if Thaos scales with us, but if not, I mean, that is a plus. We'll be able to defeat him more easily. So... we have to take the boat back. It's so anticlimactic, I can't even say. I kinda can't believe this, guys, that it's like that. I had no idea. I'm so used to playing games like... sorry. I'm so used to playing games like, Skyrim. Neverwinter Nights. Where is this guy? Oh. You haven't asked him this. It's out of curiosity. What do you know of the temple on the island? Dorval's lined face turns up towards the rest of the island and then back to you. That is the Court of the Penitents. It is a dreaded place, and one to be respected, as the gods must sometimes be feared, but always obeyed. Well, I'm ready to return to Old Song. So yeah, games like Neverwinter Nights and Skyrim, when I've installed expansions... I mean, I'm pretty sure Neverwinter Nights... it's been a long time. You can finish the game, and then you can play the expansion afterwards. Doesn't matter. You know, in fact, I prefer to do it that way. But, well, what are you going to do? It's not that way. And it would have broke immersion, but they should have had a little pop-up box saying, or at least in the loading screens, made sure it come up that, you know, once you go down the pit into Braith Amon Yemen, you cannot return, so be sure you've quested and explored everything you want to before going down the pit. That would have been nice. That would have been, you know, interesting. Or just not have it end that way. Can't believe this crap. Anyway. We're going to return to Cad Nua. I'm going to do a few levels, and then we're going to complete some companion quests, since our companions are there waiting for us. And, we got to do Radric's Hold at some point. And, once we're done with the dungeon, the massive dungeon, and companion quest in Radric's Hold, we will start the White March expansion. And they'll probably come out with Might March Part 2 while we're playing Part 1 at some point. I'm not completely sure, but I think I've only had another 20 hours, so in our terms, it's another 40. I might have it wrong. I might be saying too high, but 20 hours, if that's true, will give us 40 episodes. And, West Curtain Wall is still going. Yeah, I can't do more than one at a time. Get some rest. And then we'll head down. I guess we'll do, you know, another 4 levels. I think we left off on level 5? And whatever level it is, I know there's a stairway right near there, so we can just use that. So anticlimactic, though. I can't believe it. I had no idea that I'd be doing this, that I'd be... I like the woodland trails. No. Alright. I'm gonna buy another 2, what do you call it? Camping supply thingies, but, I think that's in the hall itself. So naturally, as long as I have it right, we're gonna skip all the Sun and Shadow crap and the Braithemon crap when we ever finish the expansions.
How do you do?
And that'll be our last episode of all. Some expensive stuff here. What are we buying? Wait. Oh. This is all we have? Where'd the stuff go? I put it back. Where the hell did that stuff go? I guess I sold it to him anyway? Whatever. Where's our camping supplies? How many do we have? 4? Good. Thank you. Right, we skip right to level 5. And there's a stairway right down to 6. A wanted criminal by the name of Nervy the Deft Hand. I'm really trying to use these three. Make sure they got experience and all that. Okay. Make those stairs go up. Well, we've definitely been here. Yeah, those stairs are going up. Very different than what I thought. So we gotta go back here. I can't even see. No traps, I hope. These stairs go down. Alright, never mind.
Light, flame, and sound. We'll keep to ourselves.
Been so long since I was here. Okay, so this is new then. Right. Okay, level 6, guys. We must be getting close. I can feel it in my bones. Also, the architecture has changed. I think Aloth said that. Let me turn off the fast stuff. You know, I thought the clinking of bones sounded like skeletons. Or the clinking of something.
Helpful.
So we are training to fight Thaos. That's our official story explanation. These guys might be very easy compared to what we've been coming against.
Following your lead.
Hey. Lava will be on seek!
Okay. Game crashed. You're really batting 1,000, aren't you?
No problem.
Well, that's Kana saying that. Kana. As soon as we had Aloth target them with his fireball, the game crashed. It was trying to... Once I, you know, got out of the game, it actually switched to windowed mode. I said it was trying to switch to a resolution 1920 by 1080, but that it couldn't. I'm already running at 1920 by 1080, so what the hell are you talking about, game? Let's try it again.
Don't even blowing it down!
Fireball. Let me wait for him to line up a little first. Oh. Oh. Yeah, don't use your hand. There seemed to be a lot more last time, or are they still coming? Alright. I guess that's it. Did he cast that spell? I guess he can't reach. I guess it's too far away. Hello there. There they are. Oh. Okay, Aloth. Now, with your spell.
Yeah.
Where is he? This last one.
Yes.
You're coming, buddy. Barely hurt Aloth. This is quite a relief after fighting Thaos and those two statues. That was tough. Those bones.
I shall be discreet.
Got it.
Well, there's another one.
Don't be mad.
How many are there? Are you screaming about Durance? Not even slowing it down, I think he said. More of them over here. Skeletal wizard and stuff. Oh, a Dargul. I didn't see those.
Hey.
Drives me crazy when the screen is moving all over the freaking place. Like that, wizard. Hello, Ranger. That Ranger was a little out of our range. Haha. I got so many of them. Now. So far, just the one, although I saw an inkling of something over there.
Lava beyond seek.
There you go. If you can stop spotting things long enough to.
Sure. Time to see and not be seen.
Just have to explore this chamber. Come on, man. Can't stop spotting stuff. A rod. Yeah, I had no idea it was going to be like this, guys. Oh my god, here's another one. I mean, as far as the what's going on with the end of the game and the DLC and all this, it's really kind of stupid.
Very helpful.
I mean, what's obvious is that they... I mean, you would hope it would make sense that they first designed the game in order to be a straight game and then decided to add content to it. Unfortunately, it was too late. But they really should have warned us in some way, I believe. This guy's so easy, I don't think there's any... I mean, he's almost dead already. Okay.
Time to see and not be seen.
Did it again. Okay.
Got it.
There sure are a lot of them around here. I hear more of them. Let's see if I can get to this without spotting something. Another potion of Lindgrass displaced image and 178 copper. Thaos scales with us, otherwise we're gonna whoop his butt by the time we finally get there after the end of White March Part 2 when we've explored all this dungeon. We're gonna be a lot higher in level. Get back here!
Brave Dalphilot.
Did he really get his sword? Oh, nope. He got his ranged out, that was different.
Eyes open.
Clear this yet, but let's kill this and then go back across. Hopefully it doesn't. Ah, there's another. There's a Dargul and a Skeletal Wizard and a Skeletal Rogue. One down. Another Dargul coming. that wizard. Can she reach from there? Probably not, so she's not doing anything. Is she like stuck or something now? Are a little tough. They don't hit for that hard, but they're take a while to kill. Nothing really surprising. You know, we're here. Might as well continue across the bridge a little bit. That's all of us.
No problem.
Maybe it ends right here. Well, apparently, it does. Trap. Something over there.
Something over there!
Alright, move us this way.
Hmm?
Undo that trap.
That's settled.
A regular sword. A rite of hidden wonders. It's +3 mechanics. Requires 4 lore. Sapphire Overseer Seal. Oh. This seal appears to be Inguithin in origin, formed of a circular piece of white adra shaped around a sapphire gem. On the back is an engraving of a stylized eye. Okay, so it's another one of those things. And 312 copper or 342 copper? I can't see through it. I'm surprised our journal didn't update with the seal. So we found another seal, but we didn't find the information about the one seal we already had. Draftin. Huh, that was Draftin. A crested hat. An expedition log page. I do not believe they will ever leave this place. I wonder if Merrick still does. It's just the two of us now, as it was when this all began. And the longer we stay, the more certain I am that it will be how it ends, too. We barely escaped the Drake. I cannot help but think it must simply not have been hungry at the time. I could call us lucky, but we will have to pass it again on the way back up. I found Andras. I don't think he was alive for long after that fall, but he made use of his time. The entire pool reeked of Makka's tears. The crooked bastard always did love his poisons. And Herbal's protective skin. Unique medium armor. +3 damage reduction. 10% of crits converted to hits. What? Oh, crits converted back to regular hits, okay. And it's fine armor, so it's +2 damage reduction. The young village of Gilded Vale was beset by a particularly territorial fire dragon in the early years of the Deerwood's colonial period. It was believed that the beast was provoked by the construction of Radric's hold nearby. The first Lord Radric cemented his popularity and that of his house when he gathered a dozen of his finest soldiers and slew the dragon himself. Herbel, the master armorsmith of House Radric, forged this armor from the beast's scales, and Lord Radric II famously wore it during the War of Defiance. Despite the armor's exceptional durability, the many scars and scratches testify to the use it saw during the war. The tree engraved on the cuisses, I don't know what that means, commemorates House Gathbin, which presided over the then earldom of Yenwood. That Lord Radric went to battle against the Earl's forces when the Earl remained loyal to Idir was a source of great irony. I had the emphasis wrong on that. So, I'm not sure he uses medium, possibly. Adair, maybe? He does. Saints War. Saints Row Armor. So does our priest and our paladin. And we have light armor. I kind of want to keep us with the same armor for whatever reason. I'm not even sure we can take Aloth's leather off. Between you and me, Aloth. Maybe I should upgrade him. I thought we couldn't take it off him. So damage reduction is a lot better. Recovery speed, you know, was a negative on both, almost the same. 10% ability area of effect. So if his area of effect will go down, unfortunately, by using this. But he'll die less often with damage reduction 9. That's a difference, you know. Yeah. About time, Aloth. You finally upgraded your armor. The first time ever in the game. Into the stash it goes. Oh, we got this stuff back? Okay. This was the stuff we thought we were selling and we decided not to sell and... Yeah. It just went back here and... Not in our stash, but in our general stuff. I kind of want to give this to Sagani, but... A war bow. Preymaker. I don't really use Sagani, so I should just give it to one of us. Oh, I'm gonna compare with... I guess we gotta... Hold on a second. We're running kinda long, I know. Oh, still! Wait. Oh, this is only usable by a ranger. Never mind. Just noticed that. Now, some of us are probably messed up.
Yes?
Hey.
I'm ready.
Following your lead.
No problem.
The space above the alcove is carved with simple hieroglyphs. So that's that. Okay, I'll advance forward, but to get that, but I'm pretty sure we'll spot something in there. And I want to end the episode here. So thanks for watching. Tune back next time when we explore more of level 6 of the Endless Paths of Adnua. Endure, and enduring, grow strong.